Hello everyone! You already know I'm not alone today. I have a special guest. My guest is from Russia. She loves to travel. She's lived in Italy. She's lived in Vietnam. She loves languages. She has a very similar channel to mine where she talks about living abroad and languages and tips to live abroad. So without further ado, from Ellie from Russia, we have Elena today.
Hey guys! Ciao everyone, it's Ellie from Russia and I'm very happy that Sonia invited me. I'm here to answer all of your questions and we're gonna have fun with our conversation.
In this video, I have two different sets of questions. The first part, questions I have for you mainly regarding Italy and your experience in Italy. Second part is my followers' questions regarding Russia. But for the people who don't know, why did you choose Italy and why Milan?
When people ask me why I decided to study abroad, I always say that I love the education in Russia. I also studied in the Russian university, but for me, studying abroad is about the experience of living abroad, of finding these new experiences, of seeing new people, learning new languages. Your way of thinking, your horizons become wider and you start seeing the world in a completely different way. I chose Italy not because I was looking for a better education, but for the sake of this experience of living there. Maybe you know about this scholarship, it's named DSU scholarship, which covered absolutely everything for international students. So it was an opportunity to study in Italy for free. Why I chose Italy in Europe? Because I would say it's the most favorite country for me in Europe. It's very different from all the other European countries, I would say, and I traveled a lot there, and I think that many countries are very similar, like Germany, Austria, but Italy has a completely unique culture. I love how people are hospitable, emotional, the food, all the cities are worth visiting, so I love Italy so much. I'm in love with it.
What were the biggest culture shocks when you first moved to Italy?
I think that these shocks are different for people from every country because people in different countries have different notion of these countries. In Russia, I would say most people believe that Europe and Italy as well are super developed countries, like much more developed than Russia. They have the wrong perception. They think that it's such a perfect place with no problems, you know, like Italy, people there just enjoy life and everything. When I came to Italy, my first shock was bureaucracy because it's so many papers, you know, it's just a nightmare. When I was doing my permesso di soggiorno, you just go to the police and then they tell you, okay, come here on December 20. You come there, then they say, oh, we forgot about you. And then I came one more and they told me, oh, we confused your birth date. So they had to redo it. It was so, how to say, disorganized.
And you were like, Italy must be so developed and perfect. And then it's like bureaucracy. Yeah. I didn't know that in Russia they thought that Europe was like super developed and perfect. Actually,
yes.
It's not part of my questions, but I thought that Russians felt a little European.
Yes, but Russia is like a mix of European and Asian, first of all. Yeah. And secondly, I think it's less rich country. I'm not sure. Many Russians actually prefer to move somewhere to the West, either Europe or the US. But I think that it's a wrong thought that countries like Italy, Spain, that everything is so perfect there. In fact, there is no perfect place anywhere because anywhere you go, you will find some things that irritate you, some drawbacks.
This is something you understand when you travel or you live abroad. Like, I love Japan, but Japan is far from being perfect. Every country has their own like problems and things. So I agree. Number three, is there anything you wish you had known before coming to Italy?
I didn't think about this actually.
I'm thinking about my husband, like for example, Italians, when we are at the table, you have to learn how to eat because if you start eating a lot at the beginning, you cannot finish your meal. So for the first year, he was always making the same mistake of like eating a lot for the, like appetizers and then he couldn't get to the dessert.
I didn't have that many cultural shocks. Of course, I had some shocks. I also talked about it on my YouTube channel. But overall, I think that Italians or Russians are not that different.
All right, so what was the thing you missed most about Russia when you were living in Milan?
I missed different events because generally I live in Moscow and we always go somewhere like the ballet, theater, some exhibitions, museums all the time because we have so many places in Moscow. But in Italy, I don't think that you do it that much, right?
COVID, I guess, because Milan,
maybe.
I'm not sure about Milan because I'm from Rome, but in Rome we have a lot of like different shows. We do have the ballet. For example, I go to the museum pretty often. But with COVID, last 2 years, home. Number five is, what's the thing you miss most about Italy now that you're in Russia?
Parmigiano, of course. Parmigiano, gorgonzola, different types of cheese, because when I came back to Russia and tried this cheese, I couldn't eat it. I thought that it was some tasteless rubber. I don't know. I couldn't eat it.
Is it really impossible to find in Russia?
You can find some Parmigiano, for example, in Russia, but it will cost you at least 20-30 euro. And it won't be that good. The food in Italy overall is a very good quality, not that expensive. I really loved your culture of food, like how you don't eat that much junk food. Your food is super tasty and healthy at the same time. And this culture of having dinner together, I lived with my two roommates. They were Italian guys. We shared an apartment. And for every evening, they would cook something. We would have an evening together.
Yes, that's true. And I always get mad at my husband when he doesn't wait for me to eat. Like if he eats without me, I'm like, you don't love me. So it's not a stereotype. So you agree.
And of course, I miss my Italian roommates and my friends from Italy.
So guys, let me remind you, I'll leave the link to Elina's channel here in the info box. But now let's move on to my followers' questions. So the first thing they wanted to know is, in general, what do Russians think about Italians?
I would say that Italians in Russia are perceived as very emotional people. We have this image of Italians who talk like this, and they just make so many gestures. They're very loud, emotional. I think that it's a bit true. I really love this about Italian people.
And we do this a lot. That's true.
When I moved to Japan,
I thought that we didn't. I thought it was a stereotype, but then I caught myself doing this so many times and I was like, okay, I guess I do it.
It's cool though. Also in Russia, we think that Italians eat pizza like all the time. They drink wine, limoncello. It's always, always warm and hot in Italy, which is not true. No, actually, I loved the weather. For me, it was perfect. For instance, in winter, autumn. In Russia, it would be probably minus 25, minus 30, but there it was 0 plus 1. So for me, it was very, very warm.
But I guess in Russia, if it's like Colorado, you know, Colorado is super cold, but the heating system in their houses is crazy, so good. You end up not being that cold during the winter, but in Italy, even though it's not that cold, inside the house, it's really cold.
Yes. Actually, this is one of my cultural shocks that I forgot to tell you about. I think it was October or November, and there was no heating at all. I was so cold. Like, as I mentioned, in Russia, it might be minus 30, but the heating is so good that at home, you are in a t-shirt, in shorts. In Italy, I was at home in many, many jackets. It was so cold.
Expensive. So the first time I went to Colorado, I was like, oh my God, it's gonna be negative 14, 15. And I brought a lot of sweaters, but inside the house, I was like, oh my God, Brian, can I borrow your t-shirt? Like I was sweating. I guess Russians think a lot of nice things about Italians.
Yes, I think that in general, in Russia, we think that Italians, Spanish are similar, which might be not true. In general, we think that these people from the south are very hospitable, warm.
For the second question, I mean, the question is, do Russians drink vodka in the morning?
Who asked this question?
There were so many questions about vodka, like, do you drink it in the morning? What's the proper way to drink vodka in Russia? So a lot of questions about vodka.
First of all, I wonder why in the morning. So they imagine that we wake up and near our bed, there is vodka and we drink it and we're ready to start our day. Yeah. I don't think that people drink it in the morning. This question is actually funny. There are many Russians who have never tried vodka. I've never tried it in my life.
You've never tried vodka?
Maybe I tried several drops. It was so awful and I never tried it again. There are many people who never drink it. But at the same time, in Russia, we have the problem of alcoholism. I don't know about the statistics, but I know that there are many people who always drink it. Usually those are people from, I would say, smaller towns, very small villages, for example, and kind of people who don't know what to do with their lives. They just complain that there is nothing to do, no opportunities, and they start drinking. Plus, vodka is super cheap in Russia.
Okay, so wrong. Stereotype. Number three, I don't know if this is true or not. A lot of people said it's true. Is it true that Russians don't smile a lot?
Yeah, there is this stereotype that when you come to Russia, you will see these cold people who are not hospitable. Maybe this stereotype is left from many centuries ago. Now, of course, people are very welcoming, hospitable. This question also depends on which countries you compare to. When you say a lot, it's very relative, you know. For instance, if we compare with people from the US, of course, I would say that you will think that, oh my God, people are so mean, because I lived in the US for a year. And when I came back to Russia, it was reverse cultural shock for me, because I thought that Russians were so even a bit hostile in the US. When you go to the restaurant, buy something at the shop, all the people would be so smiling and have this small talk. How are you? People in Russia usually don't interact that much with strangers. So they wouldn't smile at a stranger. It would be super weird in Russia.
Like, sometimes I do smile at strangers. No,
that would be super weird. It depends on the situation. For example, if you're in a bus or somewhere and you just start smiling, I think in Russia it would be weird.
Like I'm hitting on the person? I like you.
Yes, yes, yes. It would be perceived like this. After the US, when I did that, many guys started to approach me and like, but you were smiling at me, you know?
Oh, okay, okay. So this is half true.
Yeah, it's a half true. But if you become friends, you will see that Russians are super, super hospitable. If you're a guest, you will see that they're too hospitable. And if you compare to Italy, I would say that it's almost the same. Maybe not during winter when it's super cold. Everyone just wants to go home and like, no smiling, we have to run.
I understand. Just run. Go. I feel you. That was interesting. Okay, number four. Is it true that most Russians speak good English? Like they speak English well?
Not true at all, I would say. Even when I make my videos, and now I make many interviews for my channel, just go in the streets and make interviews with different people, I don't find that much people who would speak English. In Moscow, I would say you would find many around 20-30%, maybe even 40% of people who speak English, especially of our age. But if you go to other cities, even St. Petersburg, very few people will speak English. They say that it's pretty difficult to survive in Russia without speaking Russian.
Would you compare it to Italy? Because I mean, Italy is not famous for its English.
Yeah, I think that it's like in Italy. Okay. Yeah, because in Italy, I also had to learn Italian. It was very difficult to find someone who speaks English, even in Milan.
I thought Russians were better. I don't know why. Maybe because, but it's because traveling, you always meet Russians who are traveling, so they probably speak
English. Yeah, that's why.
Oh, this is interesting for me because I hate to drive. Do Russians drive worse than Italians?
I don't know how to compare, but I do remember that when I lived in Italy, I was always so irritated that drivers in Italy never pass you to cross the road. And this was shocking for me. Like, they just start driving faster, or even, you know, you go and they go like this.
You have to make eye contact and like, I'm gonna go. If you don't stop, you're gonna be in a lot of trouble. So it's like, I'm going, stop.
Well, I didn't know about this eye contact.
Eye contact, scary look. I'm gonna cross the road. You better stop.
They never passed me. I didn't have this eye contact.
I'd say maybe at least in Moscow, they're nicer to people who want to cross the road.
Yeah, in Moscow for sure, they follow the rules because I think that the fines are very high. You need to pay a lot of money if you break some rules. I don't know about other cities of Italy as well, But this is the thing that I noticed. If you go to the south of Russia, the region named Caucasus, they have no rules at all.
What do you
they
mean?
They drive as they want. So yeah, if you go to that part of Russia, it would be crazy.
It was really nice talking to you. You're really nice and friendly. Guys, let me remind you, her channel, info box, I'll leave the link.
My channel is Ellie from Russia, and I talk about the Russian culture, things that you cannot find on Google, and also travel to places in Russia that are hard to reach, like Mount Elbrus, the highest peak in Europe, or Ural Mountains, or some rural places, villages. So yeah, I would be happy to see everyone at my channel as well.
Thank you so much for being here, and have a good day. Bye guys, bye.